Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about the resolution and the components of the vectors in the plane. So here we are going to discuss that how we are going to resolve the vectors. Okay, so what is resolution? First question come. So it is the process of splitting the vectors into two or more components or two or more vectors in such a way that their resultant or the combined effect is same as that of the given vector. The vector into which the given vector is splitted are called the components of the vector. What does it mean? Suppose we have two vectors. This is my vector A and another vector I have, vector B. Okay. Now I want to calculate or I want to resolve this vector. So, as we have already seen that these two vectors are coplanar. What does it mean? Coplanar means they both lie in the same plane. So, what we are going to do is that we are going to resolve the vector A and vector B from the triangle law of vector addition. So for that, what we need to do is, suppose I am going to take a vector A and another vector B. Okay, I will take another vector B which will be coinciding. I will take this vector B and I will take this vector here. So obviously its resultant will be here. So this will be its resultant that I called it R. Okay. Let me call this point as O, P and Q. Okay. What we have done is we have taken this and you can see here that is OQ is representing the vector R that will be the resultant. Through O we have drawn a one parallel to the vectors A and B, which is meeting where? At the point P. So from the triangle law of vector addition, what I can say, OQ vector is equals to OP vector plus of PQ vector. So we have the values, we can substitute. So this is nothing but R is equals to vector A plus of vector B. If you will see here, that is OP, this line OP is parallel to vector A because we have made. Okay, so we can say that is P OP vector is equal to lambda into A vector. This is, we already know that we can use this. If the two vectors are parallel, we can write down this. And PQ is parallel to B vector, so we can write PQ vector is equals to as mu B vector. Okay, so here if you will see, that is mu and A are the scalar. Okay, mu and lambda are scalars. When they are scalars, so we can say R is equals to lambda into A vector plus of mu into B vector. So we can say from here that the vector R has been resolved in the direction of A and B. Okay, and these are the components of the given vector of A and B. So I think this is clear to you that what is the resolution of vectors means the splitting of the vector in the same manner or in the same plane, that is called the resolution of the vector. Okay, if we have to resolve the or we have to assume that we are going to resolve R in the given direction of A and B in another way, then what will happen? We will find out lambda and mu, then we can see that it will be equals to 0 and we will find out that this will be the resolution and this will be the case of the resolution we are going to see. So I hope this is clear to you. So now we have seen that the resolution of the vectors. So now we are going to discuss the orthogonal trade or the unit vectors. Okay, what is this orthogonal vectors and what is this trade or orthogonal trade or the unit vectors or base vectors? So as we are going to consider a right-handed Cartesian coordinate system, so we know that we are going to consider the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So this is my x-axis and this is my y-axis and this is my z-axis. This we are going to consider that we have x, y and z plane. So in vectors, when the three vectors, or we can say when we are considering the three units of the vectors in perpendicular to each other just like this, so then x will be represented with I cap, j, y will be represented with j cap and z will be represented with k cap. So it means in vectors, instead of writing x, y, z, I can write I cap, j cap and k cap, which means the same. Which means that x, if I am writing, it means I am writing I cap. If I am writing y axis, it means I am writing the j cap. If I am writing z, it means I am writing the k cap. So this is the representation, or we can say such vectors, or the arrangement of the collectively, or the arrangements of this unit vectors perpendicular to each other is known as the orthogonal trade of vectors, or we can say this is as base vectors. Okay, so we can say that the mod of vector I is equals to the mod of vector j, which is equals to the mod of j vector k, that will be equals to 1. Such arrangement is called the orthogonal trade of unit of vectors and the base vectors.